Good morning. Continuing with the assembly on endangered species of India, in today's presentation, we will learn about some of the endangered deers and antelopes. Both are even-toed hoofed animals and ruminant mammals, but there are some prominent differences between antelopes and deer. Male deer have antlers, which they shed and grow every year, while antelope have horns that are permanent. Also, deer antlers are branched and antelope horns are not. Antelopes belong to family Bovidae, as do sheep, goat, and cattle, while deer belong to family Cervidae. I will be talking about white-bellied musk deer, Mostris leucogaster, also known as Kasturi Mriga. The white-bellied musk deer is known by this name as it has 25 grams of a waxy substance called musk that the male secretes from a gland in the abdomen. The deer uses this to mark territories and attract females. Other deer have antlers, but musk deer has canines, as shown in the picture. Their hind legs are longer and more muscular than their shorter, thinner forelimbs, which helps them to ascend and descend from the mountains as they come down for feeding and go back up. Broad toes help them to be stable on the mountain slopes, and dense coat from keeping them warm. They prefer meadows, shrublands, and fir forests on high altitude plateau, about 2,000 meters. They are found in Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, China, Nepal, Bhutan, and Pakistan. At night, they emerge to feed in open areas and graze until dawn. They select leaves of trees and shrubs with high protein and low fiber. Their predators include snow leopard, red fox, and gray wolf. During the day, white-bellied musk deer hide in dense cover as they are shy and secretive. Males are territorial, only allowing females to enter. Males fight each other over females using their long canines during mating season. The females hide behind the bushes during the fights. Babies have white spots to help with camouflage, but as they grow up, these spots disappear. A female has one or two young at a time. For the first 2 months after birth, the young fawn hides in the undergrowth and suckles. The fawns are fully independent after 6 months. As the musk of the male deer is a source of perfumes and medicines, the hunting and trade of for the musk is the only threat to the species. Some steps have been taken for its conservation. Kedarnath Wildlife Sanctuary has watchtowers and camera traps to prevent poaching, but there are challenges. Captive breeding, which is like keeping in a zoo for increasing their numbers, failed as the animals died of diseases in captivity. The sanctuaries where the musk deer is found doesn't have enough funds to employ forest guards. These are some of the references I used for my research. How would I feel if I were a Kasturi Mriga? I would feel like giving up because all my dear friends are getting poached. I would always be in fear that any second now I would die. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Raika from class 5B. Today I'm going to be talking about the Kashmir red stag, also called Cervus elaphus hungulo, locally known as hungul. So let's start. They are found in dense riverine forests in the high valleys, mountains of Kashmir and northern Chamba district, Himachal Pradesh, mainly seen in Dachikam National Park, Kashmir. The color coat is a brownish red, which is why it is also called red deer. However, this can vary with the season and the age of the hungul. In an older hungul, the color coat is brown. Male hungul stags have long hair along their necks, while females do not. They eat grasses, sedges, the leaves and shoots of trees, and other woody plants are all on their menu. Fruits and berries are sometimes eaten too, while tree bark is taken when other food is scarce. The predators are the Himalayan brown bear, the Himalayan black bear, the snow leopard, and the leopard. Hangul are usually seen in family groups. The male deer battle with the antlers to control a herd that consists of female deer and their young ones. The herd is led by the dominant stag. Hangul are usually active during the day when they are seen grazing along the slopes of the Dhachikam Wildlife Sanctuary. The herd huddles together in a group at night for warmth and protection against the predators. Normally, one offspring per female. The gestation period is 7 to 8 months. After giving birth to their fawns, the young ones, the females too leave the lowest part of the valley and move to the upper slopes where the best and the most nutritious pastures are available, and will use these areas for raising their young ones till the weather turns harsh, forcing them down again. They are endangered due to habitat destruction, overgrazing by large herds of domestic livestock such as sheep, goat, and buffaloes. Huge sheep farms have taken over the grazing land in this region. There is hardly anything left for the Hangul. Fawns are predated upon the dogs of the security forces and nomads who graze their herds. The population of Hangul has been constantly going down. 197 deer in 2004, 182 in Dhachikam and adjoining areas in 2017. In 2013-14, an important part of the conservation project for Hangul is to study the food habits, breeding patterns and movements of the species in its habitat by tagging the animal with satellite collars. Wildlife Department in recent years started a project for improving the population of the Hangul through ex situ breeding, that is an enclosed space like a zoo. Now the department is waiting for a young pair of Hangul to be shifted from the forest without any stress and they can breed naturally. Since the year 2002, the Wildlife Department had been pleading with the sheep rearers that the farm is acting as a huge disturbance to the habitat of the Hangul. So one step is taken to remove some of these sheep farms. These are the references to the site where I learned about the Kashmir Red Stag. How would I feel if I were the Kashmir Red Stag? If I were a red stag, I'd feel special because I'm rare. But that is because I'm going to be extinct. Losing my friends would be awful. I wish I were a human where I can sit down and not be scared for our life, unlike them. I hope humans have realized their mistake and they would try and start conserving us. Thank you.
Good morning. Today, I'll be talking on black buck, which is an antelope. Scientifically known as antelope cervicapra and locally known as kala heron. Black buck lives in open woodlands and semi-desert areas, but also enjoy areas with dry forest and like to stay near grassland. They prefer areas where water is always available. Found in many states of the country, to name a few, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and Tamil Nadu. The coats of males show two-tone appearance. The upper parts and outsides of the legs are dark brown to black. The underparts and the insides of the legs are all white. Being herbivores, black bucks graze on low grasses. They prefer grass-like plants, short plants with long narrow leaves, and occasionally the trees of warm climate. Black buck's predator were cheetah. Since they're extinct in India, now their main predators are stray dogs and jackals. Breeding occurs year around, but the main birth and mating peaks occur in February and March, with another peak time at end of monsoon in August and September. During the 20th century, black buck numbers declined sharply due to excessive hunting and deforestation. By 1970s, black buck was locally extinct in several areas. As
part of conservation efforts, hunting of black buck is banned under Schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. But still, black bucks are being killed illegally. The Bishnoi community of Rajasthan is known worldwide for their conservation efforts to protect black buck. Bishnoi is considered the black buck to be the reincarnation of their religious guru, Bhagwan Jambeshwar. They have been known to make many sacrifices for the protection of animals, especially the endangered black buck. Bishnoids are perhaps the only environment-friendly community in the world that recognize the rights of birds, animals, and trees to live in harmony with humans. In 2016, over 1,700 people who were involved in wildlife crimes in Rajasthan were arrested due to efforts of this community. These are some of the references which I used for my research. If I were a black buck, I would really love to thank the Bishnoi community for conserving me and my family, and I would also like to help them in return. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ekat Murada from Class 5B. I will be talking about the Nilgiri Thar. The locals call it Paraibu, and its scientific name is Nilgiri Tragus hylocryus. It is a broad-billed mountain goat, endemic to Nilgiris. They have short coarse fur and bristly mane. Females and males have curved horns, but they are larger in males. They mostly travel in herds, and their lifespan is short. They only live for 3 and 3.5 years. They inhabit the open mountainous grassland habitat at an altitude of 1,200 to 2,600 meters. They are mainly found in the southwestern Ghats, in the hills of Tamil Nadu in the east, to the southwestern hills of Karnataka in the north, and to the Wayanad Plateau in the west. It is a herbivore. It feeds on a variety of herbs as well as grass and shrubs. The Nilgiri Thar has many predators. Some include jackals, tigers, and leopards. In the wild, they can breed up to twice in a year. The peak time to give birth is winter. They rarely give birth to twins. A single offspring is born after a gestation period of 180 to 242 days. They have a darker color when mature. Habitat loss and poaching are the two major threats to the Nilgiri Thar. Irrawaddy National Park and the grassy hills of Annamalai are the only two locations which have a population with more than 300 individuals. The majority of Nilgiri Thars reside in the mountainous grasslands, which may become unsuitable due to rise in global surface temperature, that is global warming. Occasionally, forest fires destroy their habitat. Conservation efforts have been on for quite a long time, and the numbers have recovered dramatically from around 1,000 in 1970 to around 2,600 in 2010. A conservation program outside the Irrawaddy National Park is being prepared for the long-term survival of the species. Conservation plan includes close and periodic monitoring of the Thar's habitat by NGOs, WWF team, and the local communities, and better patrolling to control illegal activities. Here are some of the references which I got information from which I got information about this topic. If I were Nilgiri Thar, here are some things I would feel. If I were Nilgiri Thar, I would think that why do hunters kill us and why do humans take our habitat from us? I like getting attention, but I still don't like getting killed. I'm happy that some of our friends are still alive, living happily in a national park. Thank you.